Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Dawn and Dusk tournament for Root, a woodland game of Might and Right. I am your host, Thewey, and we've got our players today. We've got Annoying Alchemist. We've got Cook. We have Salo Solomon. And we have Wyrados. Okay, great. So players have drawn their cards and we have gotten the flop. Vagrant in the flop, two times in a row. Actually, cats and birds as well, two times in a row. So that's fun. Okay, y'all, I'm going to mute myself here. You, of course, can call on me if you need me. Turn it over to y'all to get the game started. All right. They have forgotten the map draft. Maybe I should have gone over that with them. They're taking care of it. Oh, yes. Here, I will upgrade you all. Act responsibly. Squid Mark. Yeah, hopefully, you know, hopefully the cats win. Sure. And we've got Mountainside again. People really loving this map. I like it too. It's very trippy. Squidmark, who wouldn't pick cats first? Obviously, the OP faction in this mix-up. Gregula, are you in the game too? Okay, come join us. Yeah, apparently it is a 5-player game. This is great. I'll get another faction out to choose between. Yeah, we'll just stick Greg with 5th. Yeah. the thing is that people infamously like drop out of tournament games, and we can't like guarantee that everyone will show up. And so 5th player games like help prevent that. Would you rather play a 5th player game or a 3-player game? I think that's the question you'd ask yourself. Oh, I guess they don't actually need to be locked. We've got several red factions in the flop, so. Yeah, let's get him a faction board. Yep. Yeah, this probably isn't the best setup for cats. Especially if lizards are in the game. Ah, what would you pick in fifth seat? Are badgers even good at five player? I mean, maybe. Okay, we got Vagrant coming up. Yeah, I think cats like Vagabond. So maybe cats are a bit better of a pick now. That would be good. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the quest drafting strategy is a Gregula original. So I'm excited that we're using it in this tournament. I'm a little confused about what forest this vagabond is in. It's like, I guess he's obviously in the closer forest, but seems like he's on the path. Yeah, I think that's right, Squid. Really? Yeah, I should know that, Cole, but I don't. So, good to know. It is Gregula's custom role, so. I think maybe I would try to keep those two fox quests, maybe? I figured it out. Cole, I just checked the little Discord that the creator has for the mountainside map. And you're right, the telepaths don't divide the forest, so. Hello, welcome to the stream. What are you talking about? My Twitch custom graphics are perfect. Odd. This is a game of how low can you go? You've got vagabond lizards and crows chosen. Now they're going to have to start picking red factions. All right. It's going to be an interesting game. Is it going to be a fast game? I mean, 5 players. Perhaps not. Nightminer, are you referring to Cat Part 2 as in when my cat turned off the internet last night? Or Marquise de Cat? Like. I have taken measures to prevent cat internet outages this game. So, hopefully that works. Yeah. I don't know how to set that up, Nightminer. Let's see. What are our options? I click on more. Rules tools. If I click clearing priorities, what happens? Let me warn the players first. Hey y'all, the audience has requested clearing priority markers. I'm gonna press a button and see if it works. Okay. Oh, okay, it did work. Cool. Yeah, I wasn't sure if it would like automatically populate on whatever map it was. Yeah, this isn't fancy winter tournament. This is Dawn and Dusk. We gotta do everything by hand. Looks right. Good old Ultimate Mod with all the little quirks. Should add that to my little intro speech. Looks like we're going charismatic. Like to see it. It's down to cats or badgers. Did I hear my name implied? Okay, yeah, so what's the question? Where do badgers set up? It looks like the only two that are adjacent, well, okay, hold on. We've got these two that are adjacent and these two that are adjacent. that are not also homelands. So I think those are the two spots. This was like a sticky thing in the actual winter tournament, I remember. Okay, excellent. Problem solved. It's interesting because either way it would be a fox and a mouse set up for badgers. Interesting. Yeah, is that how you think, Decoy? I'm honestly confused by it a bit. Choose two adjacent homeland clearings on the map edge that have 2+ clearings between them and enemy homelands. Yeah, Nightminer, that does sound like what Garrick ruled in the winter tournament. Good old complicated route. So you would know, Decoy. Yeah, I think I'm gonna get to work deleting all this miscellaneous stuff. Whoop. Yeah, it's fine. I better get the turn set up. I guess we won't have turns. If they request turns, I'll give it to them, but I don't know, Nightminer. I mean, the crows are, like, trying to expose the lizards, too. Oh, man, lizards are gonna burn. Second seat. I think it might be Weirdus. Eerie. Did we have a card crafted? Ooh, old friend. Interesting. Yeah, we got a charismatic Eerie. Right. Really? Okay. Getting that two slot clearing and leaving that one slot one. I don't hate it. Move, build, recruit. It's a different sort of first cat turn. I like it too. Night Miner, you wouldn't believe it. We got our old friend the Vagrant again. Random is random. Little Vagrant. Yep, we got Spoil, this deck's version of Saboteur, an instant effect, remove Crafted Improvement. There are three in the deck. One is now locked in the Decree. Yeah, it's looking like standard opening for Charismatic, yeah. Oh yeah, didn't even realize that. That is sad. I don't know, well... Yeah, Lizards had a couple options for double building slot fox clearing. That's the spirit, Gregula. Lizards threatening crows. What was it? Was it an? It was an extort. Oh man. You are right, Night Miner. That does look like an illegal keep placement. Right, Night Miner. I definitely can't catch everything, so I'll catch nothing. I think that's a good policy. Crows jumping into the lead. Man, people really want the crows and the lizards to fight. Which sounds like a losing battle for the like two worst factions in the game. People are ruthless in Root. Crow strats I've seen lately have revolved around a lot of double plotting, just like all the time, double plotting whenever you can. Wonder if we'll have that happen in this game. Yeah, I mean, I think it's one of their main ways to stay competitive in an aggressive environment. Although it does eat a lot of their crows to do it. Ha Well, okay, just one plot. That's true. That's true, Nightminer. I do think it's important to have, like, a few crows in the supply for your raids. Hopefully they remember to empty the outcasts. Oh, it's still there. Looks like lizards are planning revenge. Ooh, gonna destroy that extort plot. I like it. True meaning of revenge. You're gonna attack the plot, right? Get a storm the keep. Lol. Oh, interesting. I don't know, I kind of think taking out the extort would have been more brutal punishment. Ooh. Got a service of the rabbits. Okay, we're not crafting either of those cards. Well, okay, maybe we're crafting service of the rabbits, but probably not, right? Oh, he's got no cards in hand right now. Yeah, let's see. That was a 1-0. We're probably going to see a Vadrant strategy, right? I don't know, Gregula sometimes does unconventional stuff, but... yeah, Cole, you're probably right. I mean, maybe in 7, they might be able to defend a rabbit workshop. So we explored, got a boot, and ate it. The cats. Pretty solid. If I were the cats, I think I'd hit, but they kind of had a slow start, so maybe not. Ooh, tricky tails. That's fun, because we don't really want a craft tea right now, but we can at least use them for ambushes. Nice. Service of the mice, maybe? I don't remember. Oh, interesting. That's a great card for charismatic. Oh, this is excellent. Having that extra battle and having that extra recruit, those things will offset each other quite a bit. Weirdos just drawn like a god. Drawing like an Egyptian pharaoh. High noon. Interesting. I mean, this could be really clutch for getting some multiple plots in on a turn. That's great. That's true. Erie Emigre. No crow in the keep, sadly. Oh, I wonder what plot that could be. Yeah, those are adjacent. Okay. That is very sad. Yeah, not many good choices. Two have plots on them, and one has four cats on it. Welcome, Flying Cactus. Oh my. Don't know that we should drag races into this. Probably not happy to see that sword. Although, get that guard duty out of the way. Gotta exhaust that torch. But nice. I mean, we all know that lizards hate birds, and crows are just a different kind of bird. Nice. Crow's big sad to lose that plot. They also didn't defend it, though, so. Okay. think I missed that aiding of the crows. Nice, I like that. Are cats planning a preemptive attack? Is that why they're asking this? Oh, we've got another night terrors on the board. I love it. There are only two night terrors in the game, so they're both out now, which is lovely. That was funny. This is great. Basically means that cats have another action. They can consistently be policing. Instead of spending it one time for one action, they can use it multiple times for the rest of the game. That's awesome. Right, like battling helps the person who is, you know, who initiates the battle, and yeah, this is great. I'm a big fan of this. Oh, could not have asked for a better roll. That is wonderful. Ooh, what are we getting? Taking a spoil. Interesting. Perhaps disincentivize other people from crafting, get rid of the birds' night terrors, maybe. Nice. Ah, Adventures is such a good card. Okay. Here you are nowhere near crafting it, though, so. Makes sense. Okay, I guess they could manage to craft it, but they need to add something to the decree. Yeah, that is a good point. The spoil is protecting their own night terrors. So. That is a great point. Birds are getting a little bit dangerously high. Lizards are having a rough game over the Morrow. Eerie are on a two-turn turmoil clock unless they turn things around real quick. Yeah, from recruit. Yeah, exactly. And they just will not lose any warriors. Yeah, they're gonna have to lose two warriors on their next turn, which they should probably do by attacking face down plots for that guaranteed loss. But maybe there's another way. Maybe just attacking large groups of warriors, but that doesn't guarantee it. Yeah, double battle. They probably should go double battle. Storm the Keep. That's a fun idea. But probably throw off the ecosystem a bit. Okay, let's see. Did I miss any crafts? Nope. Still got High Noon. Yeah, Corvids have High Noon over here, which is, you know, could be really clutch to double plot, you know, you throw down a bunch of warriors into one clearing and then immediately be able to plot there. I love it. Interesting. Lizards do have Service of the Rabbits. They can just immediately get rid of that plot. No effort. Wonder if the crows have thought about that. Yeah, crows are being a little mean to lizards right now. Classic route, just too many things to do and too few clearings to do it in. If they ask me, I'm going to tell them that's not the case because it says at start of Birdsong. So the ruling on that would be no, you have to do start of Birdsong things first, before the more lenient ones. Before exposure, because the thing is that all start of Birdsong things need to happen very first, and you can order them as you want to, but then once you do anything that's not specifically start of Birdsong, you have entered a different part of Birdsong than the start of it. Yeah. Yeah, maybe it is just a raid. I've never played Overwatch, so I hope not. They're trying real hard to talk the crows out of it. Okay. An international incident has been avoided. Rolling it all back. I'm really happy that the crow's backed down. That is really random. Cats are lost souls. Perhaps. What fox clearing are we going for? Yeah, that makes sense. That's the easiest to take over. Nice. And it has a plot on it already. Yeah, that's a good move. Ah, that would be really sweet to be able to craft coins. But... okay. Vagabond is friends with Cats and Crows currently. I don't think anyone has. Oh, Crows crafted crossbow. Crows really want to be friendly. Gula has got to have a hammer in hand, right? Or, I mean, a T in hand. They chose Vagrant first. Like, they were the ones with the first pick, so... let's see. Oh, it's sad that Gregula is out of boots. I'm assuming Gregula has a T in hand. But I might be wrong. I mean, Gregula is doing great in first place currently. He's got some aid targets set up. Okay, we did aid the lizards. That's great. No, because, yeah. No, not even a bag. It'd be like a boot. Boot's the only thing we can craft in this clearing. But that would put us over satchel limit. Oh, that is a weird choice. I guess we can trade out an exhausted shoe for an unexhausted one. So I guess there is that. Oh, tricky, tricky. Ah, of course, tossing the sword. Classic Vaderant strat. Ah, fun. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of small vagabonds. I think it obscures the board state a little bit. That is smart. Got some juicy clearings there. 12 again, becoming a very juicy clearing with cat stuff, like last night in game one. Oh, you can only recruit once. Okay, good, good. I feel like you gotta go double battle birds. Oh, good. Nice. Okay. I like this even more. Oh man, not another dominance card. Oh, that's still very sad for lizards. Two dominance cards locked in the decree. Extorted turn one. Alchemist, I feel for you, man. Interesting. Looks like we're marching into 12. We have a safety build in 9. Looks solid. Oh, that's what the birds wanted. Only 3 birds. I love how the different factions just transform, like, what a good die roll is. Oh, okay, protect the buildings. Endgamer, I feel like lizards are having a worse time, but that is a pivotal clearing to lose. Fair enough, Endgamer. Fair enough. No. We didn't turmoil. No, we got 2 battles, our night terrors. Yeah, we're gold, and we lost a ton of warriors. So birds are good. Yeah, that's a good analysis, Night Miner. Ooh, off trail. That's one of the best cards in this deck, Off Trail. Just so fun. Oh, what do we reveal? Another raid? Okay. It's only connected to two clearings that you can place a crow in because of that keep there. It can be helpful for crows since they only have three actions, but you're right, nimble does help for sure. That's a tough one, Nightminer. I mean, we don't have very many, like, fighty factions right now. Cats do have some disposable battles, but they've got a lot to do as well, and lizards definitely can't do anything, and Vagrant can't do anything, so... Right. Yeah, end game. We do have a lot of crafts crafted. Birds have night terrors. Cats have night terrors. I don't know, is military supply is good for lizards? Right? I could see that. Okay, great. We've got another suited clearing set up for lizards finally. That's great. Are we also going to score? I think that's the right call. Hopefully we can craft those coins. Looks like it is a rabbit outcast. Yes. Ah, that was beautiful. Wow, lizards looking good. Yeah, that quickly changed. I'm loving the players' table talk. It's kind of mean, but I like it. I don't know, maybe they scored in both rabbit and fox? I'm not sure. I think that might have been it, but I missed that too. Okay, so what is Vagrant gonna do? Yeah, lizards revealed a bunch of fox cards. They revealed off-trail, racket protection, or protection racket, rather, and the anvil. So they used two of those to get Garen's out and one of them to score. I didn't see them score in rabbit, but I assume they did. we got to be planning on getting a T out this turn, right? I mean, Gregula chose this first choice. And Gregula does not have the hammer in hand because Lizards just showed that. So, I mean, we got to be planning on crafting a T. Unless Gregula just wanted to try it out. Tissues and a hammer. What will we do? Getting that tea finally. Beautiful, beautiful. This happened. The prophecy has been fulfilled. Wonder if we're gonna do that. Oh, we're back short of being able to do that T quest safely. You're right. Maybe walk back to Fox and aid the Lizards. I mean, that's a little dangerous though. Lizards are doing pretty well and you don't get any points out of it, but more cards is more cards. Ooh. No, he's not hostile with anyone. It's just that he would need aid twice to get it, and he would need a boot to get over there. I mean, he could get rid of a boot in order to aid twice using the coins. Maybe that's worth it. I don't know. Sounds like he's thinking about aiding the birds, though. Birds is able to get a point from birds, so that's nice. I also like how Gregula here pipes up the Lizards. Nah, I think Adrian would want the bag. It's just a little far away. The ruins on this map might not be the most conventional. Service of the mice going off. Wonder if we can get all of the service cards off this turn. I mean, hopefully the. Everyone talked about it right in front of them, but they were trying to prevent turmoil on her crew, which they successfully did, so I don't think it was their priority. Nice. Solid. I love Field Hospital so much. Might be like my favorite card in the game. Or not card, my favorite ability in the game. Area have been well policed. They might need to start pivoting into double build. Yeah, guerrilla warfare is quite good. Agreed, Night Miner. I have a special place in my heart for the Alliance because I played them my very first game and then won with them, and then I've been addicted to Rue ever since. Oh, did we add a third card to recruit? Just totally missed that. Yeah, this is a very interesting decree. Now we're like counting on people attacking us. That's wild. Here's the decree, Cole. We got stomped on last round, so we've gone triple recruit. We got triple recruit, two battles, plus the Night Terrors battle. But everyone stomped on the bird so hard, it kind of made sense to go triple recruit. Yeah, lizards have come to a good spot. I was wondering over the morrow. They're so sad not to lose any birds. Crows are obviously happy because they can still flip, but everyone else was like, why did you destroy more birds? Got a nice stack of acolytes there. Oh, okay. Who did that? The crows? Nice. Of course they wanted to keep that plot alive. Okay, that ambush makes even more sense now. Interesting. We have the three raid plots out. Oh. Exposure just became quite a bit easier. And the crows, it looks like, have complete control over what the outcast is going to be. And we know the lizards have hammer in their hands, so are they going to... I mean, it'd be rather easy to make it not go fox. I hope so, Nightminer. That would be awesome. Where are they going? I feel like lizards would craft the hammer, like, just for the points, and then incentivize the vagrant to give them more cards. That's true. It's true. Wonder if crows are, like, thinking about how, like, they're potentially the biggest target for the Eerie. Got four crows in High Noon. They'll make an appearance at some point. That's fun. Hated rabbit, and we've got five lizards. Do we do anything with that? Guess we could recruit the crow in two and get a point off that raid. Yeah, not much going on in Rabbit. That's true. We could convert all of the ones in six or nine. That is a nine. Yeah. It's not a bad move, and we could maybe even try to go tall and rabbit. That's probably a trap, though. Tough decisions for lizards. That's fair, Nightminer. I'm very intrigued by the idea of lizard dominance. Just because they're the only faction where just outruling isn't viable. Oh, we have 5 Eerie on the board. That triple recruit was definitely the right move. Over to 2, right? Oh. Interesting. The tension, will he ambush? Oh, that was, yeah. Okay. They are now hostile. Okay, one dominance not locked in the decree. That's nice. Yeah, maybe you take over it. Okay, I like this. Looking good. I think we're going to be crafting. Okay. I take back what I said. We can't actually craft the hammer right now. Good old lizard crafting. I assume we're going to be seeing some aiding this turn, but who? Finally getting a bag. But doing so at the cost of not repairing anything. Interesting. I mean, I guess this makes sense if we're going to be like aiding the crows, for example. Oh yeah, I think maybe we're aiding the crows. Oh, birds have a bag too. Ah, my, things just fly past you when you're commentating. Okay. Yep, yep. We're gonna... Okay. Oh, this is a very good turn. I like this. Like this for the vagabond. I do not like the vagabond this small. I do not like it at all. Where is the vagabond? I can't even see the vagabond. Where is it? It's true. I do like poetry. Where are you, vagabond? Does anyone see the vagabond? Mm. Oh, there it is. Holy moly. Oh. Great Gula, why? Why did you make it so small? Okay, we're on to the cat's turn. Cat's recruiting. Looks like they built as well. Cats do have 3 sawmills out. They're looking all right. Okay, chat, we've had some people pass 15 points. Who do you think will win? Ooh, we got Sly Dog. Did not realize that. Bunny and Build, Fox and Move. Interesting, because one of those rabbit clearings is going to be very hard to build in. But we do have three that are very under defended, so. Think I like it. Gonna have to move a bit creatively to be able to get everywhere we need to. We got. Seven's going to be hard to get to. Need to build in two clearings. Okay, we got our two builds set up. We gotta do two battles. Here, we can take a real quick look. So what's looking like? We got two coins, a bag. Two damaged items, three boots, four boots. Oh, that's looking real good for an aid setup. And a T. Okay, so we do have. You're in a bit of a bind, but I think they're going to be just fine. Oh, if crows have another ambush, they've probably saved their plot. I think it might be worth getting rid of Night Terrors at this point. Get that extra hit. Get a point out of it. Guess you can keep it though. Let's see. Crows. Ooh, tricky claws. Can now start using sword cards as fox suited ambushes. So that's fun. It's amazing how few birds are on the board with a triple recruit charismatic. Yeah, probably not then. Not with that map. Yeah, probably best just to get rid of all their non-rabbit roosts. Crows, crows. Two plots on the board. Definitely not viewed as the threat right now. Probably justifiably so. That's very generous. I would move and exert to plot. That's what I would do, because you can't not plot, right? Go to 7, probably. Yeah, that's what I would do as a crow. I really want the crows just to play their own game right now. They've really got to start plotting to have a chance. Ah, just put him in seven and plot. That's the play. Put him in seven and plot the crows. Come on. I feel like the crows did enough. They destroyed a roost. Yeah. I don't like this. This feels like other people taking the crow's turn. Oh no, we lost Greg. I am glad to see a plot, but it just seems irrelevant with the service of the rabbits the lizards have. I mean, I guess it could be a raid, so you could get three warriors, but you've lost three warriors to get it. Yeah, kind of an at zero, but I guess he did just gain two clearings that you could plot in. Okay, we've had Service of the Mice, Service of the Rabbits go off. For Service Bingo, we just need Service of the Foxes. Really? Okay, interesting. That's smart. I like that. That's a stretch. That's a stretch. That's pretty funny. Feel like birds might be gaslighting. Yeah, they got it. They got it. Probably Dom swap the rabbit card. Oh, good. Okay, let's see what this Vagrant can do. Mean, 16 points one turn, probably not going to happen. But if they can put themselves on a two-turn plot after this, two-turn clock after this, then I think they've got a real shot. But I don't know, maybe the others outrace them anyway. Hello, Thewie, voice of reason here. Could you maybe just make him regular size? That would help. I've definitely lost track of him multiple times over the stream, too, so thank you. Okay, we got black possum now. Perfect. Sad we can't see its cute little face, but that's fine. I don't know. Can Vagrant win in three turns? Because they most certainly go to the force if they have a really good turn. I don't know. Do just the lizards and the birds outpace? No. What is Vagrant planning? That's two cards and a bag. Very nice. It's a back, right? Interesting. Oh yeah, might as well do that logistics help quest, right?
the birds.
Nice. And then what do we recruit? Or maybe overwork again. I mean, lizards come out of this looking pretty good. Yeah, they did. I feel like they were helping the table too much. You know, taking suggestions from people too much. And people were very free with suggesting how the crows live their lives. You're not doing your night terrors? You have night terrors, though. Why? Such a waste of a bird card. I mean, I guess you're getting a point because of that roll. Ha ha ha. Oh man, it's becoming like your game night miner-ish. I guess that was build, not recruit. Beautiful. We saw a sword used as an ambush card, made possible with the tricky claws. Crafted improvement. Interesting. And then Night Terrors battle the plot. That'll do it. It's so hard to watch out for every contingency. I'm curious about where the Vagrant is right now. 3 damaged items, 5 cards. Don't listen to him, Crows. Hoping Crows just take their own turn. I'm excited to see this High Noon go off. Ooh, we could get a triple plot with High Noon. But then we would want to exert to protect it. Are we gonna put him on? Oh yeah. That is beautiful. A six crow High Noon. It's the most I've ever seen. I mean, it's cardboard for the crows, though, and it makes it so the birds don't come after their plot they just laid down. You can see why crows want to do this, but it probably isn't in the best interest. I don't know. What, birds get 4 points, maybe five if they go triple build, and then they just need one cardboard point. I don't know. See why the crows want to do it, though, at least. Nice. I respect that. It's a good solution. I can see Vagrant maybe winning before that. We'll see. I mean, lizards are gonna craft a hammer. They would need 3 more points than double scoring crafting the hammer. Which doesn't seem likely.
I don't think he did. Nice. 3 points away from victory. Hello, Rudy. Welcome. Things are going much more smoothly today than yesterday. Cats so desperately want a bird card. Wonder if they could win. Probably not, but I haven't done the math. Okay, nice, nice. See them 2 points. I do like choosing the crow as they target. They're the least threatening right now. I mean, they can get to 23 if all their plots go off, but still not enough to cross the finish line. Rudy, you missed a 6 crow high noon, which was lovely. It was beautiful.
Dang, that's very sad.
Cards must not be good because we have a lot of aid potential going on right now with questing and the cards, but Jessica Gula did the math right. To the crows. That's 6 points. I mean, you could move and quest, right? Move, do the errand quest. Hope for the right cards. I think this is still possible. No, I guess we're short on items. That's what's going on. And lizards are one turn ahead of you, so. That's why Sala was begging so hard for it. It's fun watching players in turmoil. Oh no, the scatting has begun. Yeah, it has the same amount of ambush cards, but then, you know, look out for those cards that let you use item cards as ambush cards as well. like we added one mouse card to move and one rabbit card to battle. That's true. Could be useful. Get a bird later. But probably not in this game. I think attacking the crows was the way to go. That's all they needed was one point, right? That's a beautiful way to end it. All right, sweet. All right, good job, everybody. Great job, Erie, for finishing that out. So Wordos, you'll advance to the semifinals of the Dawn and Dusk tournament. Everyone else, thanks for playing. Appreciate having you on. You in the audience, if you're not a follower of my channel, I'd love for you to follow it, and to also like the Design in Progress YouTube channel. We'd really appreciate that. You can join us tomorrow at 8 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time for our next game. Until then, see ya.